It's just really gross.
Marine ecologist Sarah Henkel is talking about these crab stomachs she's storing for research.
Some stomachs in jars.
We met up with a researcher inside her lab at Oregon State University's Hatfield Marine Science Center in Newport to talk about a study she did on Dungeness crab. There's no question Dungeness crab is a big deal in Oregon. In 2018 alone, they pumped an estimated $75 million into the economy. But the industry has recently run into some problems. Domoic acid, which poisons the crabs, is one of them.
But we are seeing new threats to the fishery. There's been a lot of closures due to domoic acid.
So Henkel wanted to find out once and for all how the crabs were getting the acid.
Where do they eat and what do they eat?
She partnered with researchers from NOAA and the Oregon Department of Fish and Wildlife and set out to sea to find out. The researchers glued small acoustic tags to the backs of about 30 crabs, then deployed these acoustic receivers to track the crabs' movements. Now the scientists are still waiting to analyze the crabs' stomachs to find out where they're getting the acid, but they did learn the crabs would travel over 50 miles to find food. And in areas like marine reserves where food was abundant, they would stay put.
Definitely the fact that they stuck around so long near the reef was surprising.
What the researchers learned about the crabs was no doubt surprising, but what they accidentally discovered by listening to those signals, some might say, was even more intriguing.
I recognized the 20 tags from the crabs that I threw in there, but then there's about 40 or 50 other tag numbers on there that were not the crabs that I threw in there.
Some of the sounds came from migrating sturgeon, but there were seven that came from an unexpected visitor.
The seven of the tags were great white sharks.
Great white sharks that had been tagged in Northern California and were found swimming not far off our shores, but surprisingly close.
In the 3 years that I've used this technology, 7 miles off the coast of Newport, I never heard from a shark. And when I put these in the marine reserve within about a mile from shore, all of a sudden I heard this handful of sharks.
The sharks were all looking for food within a mile of our shores, something that shocked even the scientists.
When I told my ODFW collaborators who were planning to go scuba diving there the next month, they gave them pause.
So not only do crabs like the reefs and the food they offer, so apparently do great white sharks. And researchers now have the pings to prove it. In Newport, Keeley Chalmers, KGW News.
That's interesting stuff. You know, so the researchers are telling Keeley at this point it's a little too early to tell if there's any impact here with some of the stuff they're trying to find out. But their findings are going to go back to the lab. They're going to analyze them. We hope to get some more answers from these researchers in the coming months.